Can he be successful in his endeavours this time? Really sharp start from the English boys on the far side there in all black, and the French guys, Gicquel and Labar, on the near side. And although they are unseeded, they did win the Czech Open this year, so they have got a victory under their belts, which will give them huge amounts of confidence. Really exciting match here in Prospect.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see how Labar's earlier activities this evening in the mixed doubles quarterfinal will impact here.
Played once before this couple at the Dutch Open earlier this year, with the French pair coming out on top and getting off to a good start here, 3-1 up. English boys, a couple of errors early on.
The usual fast, frenetic start to men's doubles that we've come to expect.
Indeed, this the third of the four matches this evening, with France against England.
Catching the English boys a little bit off guard there.
Yeah, but so far it is 2-0 to England, so the French boys will be keen to try and progress to the semi-finals and get one back for France. Service for fault called. As you say, Jill, it's a fast and furious start. Doesn't feel like either side has really settled yet.
No, these are early exchanges, definitely. Oh, and that's a nice shot there. Ben Lane just driving that shuttle cross court.
Yeah, quite an unusual return of serve, but.
On court number two, we have a women's doubles quarterfinal from Canada, Rachel Honduras and Kristen Tsai, and their opponents from France, Emily Rothel and Anne Tran.
False serve there means the French going to a 5-4 lead.
Yep. Interesting left hand, right hand combo, Lane and Vendy. Often be quite difficult to play against.
Apologies. Game record number two should be Delphine Delroux and Leanne Parallero from France, and from Germany, Johanna Galachewski and Lara Kaipan.
And Labar finding the inside hip there of Lane and forcing an error. Interestingly, it's more about accuracy here in the hall tonight than out and out power. In those right areas in attack.
And Gicquel just pushing that shuttle long there. Sean Vendy just pushing that shuttle wide on serve there.
Standing rally, and the English boys getting away with it there. A change of racket, leaving it late on the baseline. Ultimately, French guys couldn't take advantage.
Yeah, the French are a bit annoyed at themselves for that one.
Vendy's got a really difficult serve to attack. He really chops at it here to watch his low serve.
I think they heard you, Dave.
French guys just can't afford to give away cheap points like that straight off the serve. Again, it's a really tight serve, this time going short.
Strong defence there, but the English boys coming out on top.
Yeah, and it really is all about getting that lift. So far there's been a lot of great first, second, third, fourth shot of the rally play. But the team that's managed to come out on top has often been the one that's forced the lift.
And that's good play out there from the English pair.
Yeah. Again, great low serve, looking for that net reply really early. Third shot of the rally, finishing it off, taking the boys to an 11-7 advantage at the first interval. Coach is coming on with 90 seconds. Talk to the players, give them some tactical advice or encouragement.
And the English pair seem very pumped up for this, don't they? They seem they're raring to go. Definitely.
They do seem extremely up for the fight here and very pumped up, as you say, Jill. By contrast, you know what, are you sensing Labar maybe feeling a little bit of a hangover from his previous defeat earlier on this evening?
Possibly. With the aerobic abilities of these players, it shouldn't. However, yeah, they maybe just need to step up a little here.
French guys putting lots of pressure on the serve and managing to win that point there, staying on the attack.
Churchill just drifting along there.
Again, just feel the bar. Instead, that be a little bit sharper in that area.
Umpire just having a quiet word there. Not quite sure what that was all about. A very loose shot on the net there. Not sure that's quite what Gicquel meant to play.
Again, Vendy serving extremely well there, making it difficult for the French guys. Bit snatchy on that third shot that time.
A little bit, but the French need to steady the ship here and get back into this.
Yeah, absolutely, and this men's doubles in particular, when the shot was getting hit so hard, and it's all about the attack. It'll be interesting to see how decisive the better end is at the moment. It's not helping the French guys. 14-9 down.
Still drifting along there, but I have to say it definitely feels as though the English pair just have that little edge in terms of that sense of urgency about them.
Yep, French guys getting vocal though, trying to get each other more motivated, more pumped up. Momentum can shift so quickly in these games, but at 15-10 up, it's firmly with the English pair. Vendy opting for the flick serve there as a variation and managed to win a pretty cheap point in the end, extending the lead 6 points.
Feels like quite a decisive lead at this point.
Solid hit from Labar there, probing down the middle with the left right hander, both forehands to the inside, but then ultimately changing it onto Lane's backhand side and getting the winner.
Yep, French getting vocal again.
Yep,
taking that point.
Trying to get into this. There's a danger it could just drift away if they don't do something in the next couple of points here.
Oh, that was a great exchange there, and it sounds like a string has gone.
String's gone, yep, and French guys certainly fighting their way back into this one after being 16-10 down. Vendy just testing out the strings in his replacement racket. Can Gicquel continue with his effective serving? Service fault called. And that's a big boost to the English pair.
They've got their noses in front again.
Yep, and just things aren't going the way of the French guys. Service fault, header into the net, it's just drifting now.
Oh, that net cord will help.
So far it has really been all about the serve receive, third and fourth shot of the rallies. And the English guys have been stronger in that department. There's a bit of urgency from Labar trying to get himself going. Cool head of the English boy, just taking a break. Slow it down a little bit. Catch breath.
Nice exchange of play there.
Yeah, and definitely got their tails up now. Labar and Gicquel looking a little bit more confident.
Yeah, they're a bit more fired up here, aren't they?
Can't help but feel that the English boys have still got the quality in their returns to keep their noses in front. Really solid intervention from Vendy.
Very much so. The lift not quite high enough to get past Sean Vendy. Very good smash there from Thomas Gicquel.
Yeah, catching out Vendy, who's standing cross court and really accurate hitting the inside hip. Very difficult for Vendy to return that. Keeps it very tight at 17-19. That's well left, and from nowhere, the French guys are right back in it.
Absolutely, they've taken it to them.
Gicquel is serving well.
18-19.
Oh, that's great play from Lane. Really sharp, cutting out Labar's cross-court drive.
Absolutely, rack it up at the net there.
And it's first game point for the English boys.
But they're still in it.
Yeah, bit of a chance there. They got the lift, but couldn't put it away. Smashing into the net. He won't be happy with that. This is a huge point now. All square, 20 all.
I think this is the first setting we've seen this evening. Exciting times.
Great hit there. And momentum shifting back to the English boys. This is their third game point of the first set. Can they put it away this time? And there it is.
They'll be very happy to take that.
They will. They would have been really kicking themselves if they hadn't managed to take that first set, having gotten into such a great position. It did look like the French guys had came right back in it. But ultimately, a 22-20 victory in the first set for the English guys sets them up very nicely. Going into the second set. The French guys will take a little bit of heart from the fact that they were able to come right back into it. They definitely got the quality there. Just have to try to be a little bit more consistent.
Absolutely, and it does look like that earlier mix has had no real impact on Labar. Playing very strongly there.
Yeah, I think you called it right at the start though, Jill. The English guys did look like they were a lot sharper out of the blocks, and it was only really in the second half of that first set that the French guys got going. We're going to have to get right on it from the start here to have any chance. Arguably on the tougher end, playing against an English pair that are serving extremely well, and that's really tough.
Yeah, I'll be very interested to see the reaction of the French here.
So it's Vendy to serve to Gicquel as we start this second set.
Oh no, stop for a little chat with the umpire. Good start for the English pair. Good.
Yeah. Stunning cross-court hit. Mm-hmm. Finds a big gap there. Vendy hitting it really well.
Gicquel attempting to hit that between the legs, always going to be quite a challenge.
Yeah, and obviously lifting it into what would normally be the backhand corner, but Lane, being the left-hander, is able to come out of that corner very strongly. And Vendy combining well to finish off the rally 2-0. And again, the French guys just don't look like they've got that same urgency that they had at the end of the second set.
Yeah, they look as though they've started in a similar manner to the way they started the first set. Although that's pushed wide.
English boys questioning that a little bit, but yeah, it's called out.
I don't envy the position of a line judge.
That's nice play from Labar, finding a net cord, keeping it tight, not giving away the advantage, giving away the lift.
Shuttle goes long at the back of the court, and it's 4-2 to the French pair.
Yeah, and suddenly they look interested again. Gicquel closing down the net so quickly there. And Labar will be annoyed at himself for that one.
Yeah.
We've definitely got a match on our hands here.
Absolutely. Square now, 4-4. A little mix up or miscommunication there.
Yeah, Lane going for a bit of a cheeky flick serve there. It was an unusual serve and unfortunately it didn't pay off for the English boys. Labar looking sharp enough to react quickly. Last few points, just a little bit scrappy.
Yeah, both pairs will want to settle this down a little bit here.
Vendy's serve has been so solid so far in this match, so that's a first real error that he's made on serve. And that's an opportunity missed from Gicquel. Closing down the net extremely well, but not able to quite finish off the rally.
With that.
Yeah, that was a really great rally. The attack changed three times. The French guys getting on the initiative. It was a behind the back shot and then ultimately the English guys managing to regain the attack and finish off the rally. 7-0.
Shuttle drifts long. And the French are back in front. When that little net cord there proving decisive for the English pair.
Yep, getting on the attack and taking advantage of it. serve, third shot again.
Yep.
Vendy.
That was a very good attack and play from the English pair again. They do look very fired up for this match, I have to say.
Yeah, and it looking like Gicquel has taken a lot of the pressure. I always wonder if they're starting to target him a little bit more than Labar. And he had been dealing with it very well in that rally. There was some good stuff from him. Ultimately, the English boys coming out on top there, 10-8.
Some nice play there, though.
Yeah, it's very tight. Gicquel's on some really good touches around the net. Just drifting out there, yep. Some great attacking play from both teams and also excellent defending, particularly from the French boys digging in deep there.
Bringing it back to 10-all.
Really well played, particularly by Gicquel, managing to close down the net and then ultimately Labar putting it away.
Yeah, the French are getting fired up for this here.
On court number 3 now, women's doubles quarter final, Emma Carlson and Johanna Mats.
So quick turnaround and 90 second interval, the boys are ready to go and it's first blood to England, bringing it to 11-all. Lane to serve to Labar.
Oh, some great defensive play there.
Yeah, nice wee between the leg shots from Lane. Unfortunately for the boys, not quite good enough. Again, Gicquel showing himself to be dominant when he gets his tail up at the net.
...13-11 to France. Going a little bit loose there in the return. French pair taking full advantage.
Labar onto that really early. Great backhand drive. And it just catching the English boys' racket on the way past and causing a fault. Big point coming up, 14-11. Oh. And that's pretty cheap from Gicquel, but actually nice return from Vendy. bringing the English boys back into it, 12-14.
Oh, and that's a good smash from Labar, setting that up for Gicquel to put away. And the French have taken a bit of a lead here, 3-point gap at 15-12. Out. That's on the carpet.
French guys really turning the screw, keeping the pressure on. And looking pretty sharp. It was a great serve from Labar. From that point on, they did look in control.
Change of shuttle here, maybe just breaking that play slightly. England pull that back, it's 14-16. Oh, and that was a nice shot initially from Labar to set that up.
Yeah, and I thought Vendy did really well, but ultimately I think the French boys managed to just keep that in the court there, and at 17-14 they're looking favourites now to take this to three sets.
Gicquel just questioning the umpire there. Good attacking play there from the English pair.
Yeah, Vendy dominant at the net and giving them a real chance back in it again at 16-18. He has been serving really well. Can he keep it going?
That's a big point there for the English player.
Massive point, yep.
They want to take this in two sets if they can.
Vendy going round the head from the back of the court, setting lane up for a pretty easy forehand win.
That's a good smash there from Gicquel.
Yeah, he gets up so well there, and what an incredible angle he got on that. Bringing it down really steep cross court, putting the French guys back into the driving seat, 19-17. Great hit from Lane. Again, the lift coming up to his forehand side as a left-hander, and he's putting that away really well. really fast interchange there, but the French guys always on top and giving themselves 2 game points.
They're fired up, they're ready for this.
One saved. Vendy to serve to Labar. Second game point, 19-20. Big point.
Oh, that was a let off there.
And that is a massive let off. French boys should really be walking off the court now, getting ready for a third set. But here we are again, 20 all. Been here before, and the last time it went in the English boys' favour.
Shuttle lands in, 21-20 to the French.
That's a nice shot straight up the line. Second, third game point for the French guys. Oh, it's out.
Oh, and it's out. It's out. Oh, wow.
Almost looking like they'd got caught out there with both French guys pressing the net, but actually the shuttle drifts long. And we've got a third set.
Oh, exciting times here. It's Vive la France at the Emirates Arena.
Yeah, 22-20. 22-20. Both sets split evenly. And it brings us into a very exciting third set in prospect.
And here we go at the start of this third set. Who's your money on, David?
I'm going to go with the French guys in this final end. I honestly think having come through that difficult second set, especially being 20-18 up and then the English guys pegged it back, they managed to get 22-20. I just feel they've got it in the locker to see this one through to a finish. Interesting, right from the start, they're on it this time, and I don't think I've seen them do that in either the first two sets. They've been a little bit slower to get going.
Yeah, that's a very good point.
A lot of this depends on how the English guys now respond. They are not going to go down without a fight.
Absolutely not. No, they are certainly fired up for this. I think this is going to be very tight.
Gicquel just catching the tape there, he'll be disappointed. 2-2. Ah, that's brilliant play from Lane. Flick serve. Labar tried to hit him with the cross-court smash, but he was looking for it, and counter-attack.
Yeah, found the gap. Very good shot indeed. Going a little bit of showboating there as the mock hits that shuttle.
Yeah, and you just sense there's a little bit of needle on the court now. It was a really good flick serve from Lane, caught Gicquel out, but he managed to get back, just couldn't quite keep his backhand in the court. And that's brilliant play, yeah.
He's onto that very quickly there, isn't he?
Definitely a bit of eyeballing going on. How will the French guys respond? This is an important run of points for the English guys. Can Lane keep it going?
Important for France to close the gap there.
Yeah, and I just wonder if that's the English guys responding to some noise that the French boys were making at the start of this set here. We're definitely gearing up for a very exciting finish. String's gone there. Yep, is he going to try and change his racket again? Oh, he's away. Oh!
And the French boys played exactly the right shot to get the English pair into trouble there and then just hit the unforced error.
Yep, Labar maybe just trying to force it because he's seen that the racket change was coming from Lane. And now the English boys have opened up a very important 4-point lead here. Vendy to serve to Gicquel. Goes for the flick again. Oh, that's solid.
Absolutely, yep. That's the second time. Is it second? Maybe third time he's done that in this match.
Interesting though, Lane from the back of the court hitting the more controlled smash, not going full out. But Vendy, very sharp intercepting that round the head.
Yeah, always looking for that shuttle.
Ebbing and flowing here, and French guys, a couple of points back on the board. Managing to get on the attack and get the winner.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's important that they didn't allow that gap to become any bigger. Sean Vendy onto that very quickly there. Getting that winner.
Yep, and keeping that 4-point lead.
A 4-point lead becomes a 5-point lead. England very much in control here. And that shuttle goes long, meaning it's 11-5 going into the break.
Yeah, a couple of errors there, and the English boys will be absolutely delighted. A very commanding lead at 11-5. very much in the driving seat. If they can keep it solid and hold their nerve, there's no reason why they can't win this match.
We're just seeing that change of racket there in the replay. Yeah, the French will be annoyed at that. There was an opportunity there.
Interestingly, both pairs have lost in what has supposedly been the weaker end. But the English boys are now changing to the stronger end, which hasn't proven to be decisive in this match so far. But can they carry forward this 11-5 lead? And that's pretty sharp from Gicquel.
Six 11, important to close that gap, not allow that to become any bigger.
Felt like a late call.
Mm-hmm. And he'd caught him with that flick as well.
French boys are slightly unhappy.
Umpire's looking for a word. Or two.
And it's definitely in the favour of the English guys at the just shaking the French emotions somewhat. 12-6 up in the driving seat. Beautiful behind the back shot from Gicquel, but ultimately fighting a losing battle there, and the English boys really turning up the pressure now. 13-6.
Oh, and Vendy again, so quick. So quick to intercept.
Yep, the French guys are going to have to work very hard and require a few good runs of serving here if they've got any chance of getting back into this match. Well, that's a bit snatchy from Vendy. Not seen him do that before.
No, that was quite loose, in fact. It's been much more controlled for this match.
And a clash of rackets from Labar and Gicquel brings the English pairing to a 14-8 lead. Still that 6-point gap.
In. Fifteen-8 now for the English players, which does feel like quite a decisive advantage here.
Yep, I think they've just got to close it out now. Some good serving. Don't give anything away. Gicquel jumping that a little bit. And it's just drifting away here now. 17-9. Vendy in lane. 4 points from victory.
Gicquel into that very quickly there.
Sharp around the net from Gicquel.
Yep. They need a run of points here.
Brilliant cross court drive from lane. I guess you've got to question where he's channeling that attack. Kind of really opened themselves up there, the French boys. But can lane just see this game out now?
Oh, and the shuttle goes long.
Yeah, just getting a bit excited.
Yep, just keen to close this out.
11-19.
And rumour reaching us here in the commentary position that Sean Vendy started his badminton playing career in Orkney. I don't know if anyone out there listening to this evening could confirm that, however, possibly there's Scottish blood in Sean.
Yeah, I think that's right, Jill. He's 22 years old and started playing at the age of 5 in Kirkwall in Orkney before moving to England at 7 and became an English national badminton team member in May 2015.
Oh, some great attack in there.
Yeah, that was an incredibly good hit from Gicquel setting up Labar at the net. He really got a hold of that one.
He'll take that. He'll take that. So it's 20-12 and match point to the English pair. Shuttle lands in. I think Lane was wishing that shuttle out there.
Yep. 13. 20, 7 more match points to save. And that's game. A victory for the English player. Lane and Vendy. Decisive in that third set, 21-13. Taking those guys through to the semi-finals, which will take place tomorrow. And that sets up an all-English semi-final pairing match against Marcus Ellis and Chris Langridge against Richard Eidstadt and Peter Keisberger up next. And if the English boys, the top seeds, come through that match, they will meet Lane and Vendy in the semi-finals. So that's our next match up on court one is Marcus Ellis, Chris Langridge, top seeds, versus Richard Eidstadt and Peter Keisberger.